Let me introduce the unique activities problem. You are given a string S and you want to return a substring of S which occurs only once and which is as short as possible. If there are multiple ones of the same length, you return just leftmost. For example, if you are given a string AABAABB, you go through all the single letters A, B, they are both repeated. So you look at the substrings of length 2, AA is repeated, AB is repeated, BA occurs only once. The answer is BA. BB occurs only once too, but it's after BA. We had two solutions within the time limit, a suffix tree, which is linear in time and space, and a bisection over the shortest length with the use of rolling hashes, which is N log N. A suffix tree is a tree which contains all the suffixes of the string. You can make that in linear term. For example, for the string banana, it contains all the suffixes e, ne, ene, nene, and so on. Once you have a suffix tree, a substring of S is a path starting at the root and stopping somewhere in the tree. Now, if you want a unique substring, you start at the root, you go as far as possible, and you stop at the last internal node. You are going to have at least two leaves. This means that the substring so far is not unique. If you want to make it unique, you add one character from the last edge. For example, here, you could make the unique substring I, ne, and add one N here to make NN, which is unique in banana. Pointers to leaves can be kept during construction to avoid having to go through the tree once it is built. So you go through all the leaves, and for those who have a last edge where you can add one character, you just compute the length of the unique substring by subtracting the length of the last edge from N, and you take the minimum. Now, OUConen is lengthy to re-implement if you don't have it in your book, so there's an easier solution in N log N. You binary search the length of the answer, and for each length, you check if a unique substring of that length exists with a hash table. That is only N log N, though, if your hash function executes in constant time. So for that to happen, you want to be able to compute the hash of a substring using the hash of the previous substring, I plus 1 to J plus 1, using I to J. You can do that if you have a hash, which is, for example, polynomial. So if you have the hash of I to J, you remove the last factor, multiply everything by your prime p, and add the character j plus 1. However, you have a solution which is even faster because hash tables force lots of cache misses. So if instead of a hash table, you store all the hashes in an array and you sort them, theoretically it's slower, but to an actual computer it's faster. So that's what I love about this problem. You have three completely different solutions, and the fastest is not always the one that is the fastest theoretically.